Okay, so here we are. S1000 RR. That R1M though. That R1M though. Loved it. But then that's probably because I got a little bit more used to the track, so it wasn't quite as scary. So we'll see. If I love this as well, might be worth going back to the ZX10 later and just seeing how good it is. But I just felt so much better on the R1. It doesn't matter about lap times and shit. We're not racers. It just felt so much better. I enjoyed it way more. And that's what counts. Hey, he's got one. What mode are you going to go in?
This is in race mode at the minute.
I think I'm going to go into slick but turn the traction up.
I'm knackered already.
So am I.
Right, what do I do with this thing? TCS3, SCS2, power, is power 1 right?
Yep, power 1, mode traction B. 3. It's like, yeah, that's good.
Mode A? No, mode B.
Yeah.
Okay. But how do I, oh right, yeah. How do I change the dash?
To what? This feels heavier in my legs. It feels quite heavy, this bike, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Feels well heavy. That feels so light, doesn't it?
It does. Feels really stiff.
Well, it turns quick when it's, once you get it going. This is the worst corner on the track. It's got the blipper though. This engine feels rampant. severe brake fade. I need to adjust the lever. Well, that was on the highest setting, so... Okay, well, I'll just have to not brake quite so hard. That's not good. How many laps was that? Two? But having said that, that's actually surprised me how good it is. I didn't think it would be this good on track. I heard lots of reports saying it was a bit mushy and a bit squishy. When they work, she's got to keep calling them down. Between race shift and road shift. One thing you really don't want to have around here, brake fade. But other than that, the bike's actually really sweet. It's fuel. Beautifully. Fucking dead. He's fucking dead.